thing to realize until you come to the last 3-4 slokas. What Krishna says in the whole Bhagavad Gita is, he says, at least in 18 chapters, it says 18 times, leave the fruits, leave the fruits, leave the fruits. That means to say, you don't need to ask for, I want to pass my exam, I want to go to my school, I should get the bus, God help me. You don't ask for any fruits. Don't ask. He will give you what your karma commands. He will give you. He is very sweet person, no mistake of God at all. Don't ask for fruits, he said. Obey his order. Be obedient to him. Don't ask for any fruits. I want to pass in this exam. I want to come past crank. No, don't ask. Because Bhagavad Gita says, don't ask for fruits. I did today arati to you. I did this to you. No, don't say I did. You have got no, you can't do anything in this world. You are an Atma, Anu. You cannot perform anything. Only he can perform. He is pervaded the whole universe. Pervaded means he is inside every Atma. That the very subtle Atma is itself is Anu. Anu means, I think you know what it is, dust. It's an atom. So he is inside that. What must be that Lord's power to get inside that? That is the power he has got to think for everybody. And he says, leave all the fruits. Then second, he leave all dvandva. In all the 18 chapters, he keeps on repeating, leave dvandva, leave dvandva. Dvandva means cold heat, profit loss, sadness, happiness, leave that. That means you'll ask why we should not be happy, why we should not be sad. Yes, you should be happy and sad. For what? Once you look at the whole material world, people are happy, people are sad. They don't get something what they want to achieve. What they want, they will not get it. They'll feel sad. What they get, they will be very happy. So both, Krishna says, leave it. Don't bother about it. He says these things continuously in all the chapters. So we have to understand the whole thing, that this whole life, what he has given us, is fully controlled by that Lord alone. And we are only this Anu atom. With this, we have to lead our life doing service to him. What is service? You have to day in and out do puja to him. Do bhakti to him. He is such a sweet person. There is no other sweet person than him. Such a wonderful Lord we have got. Owner we have got. We are all servant. He is the owner. So we have to obey to his command. So this Bhagavad Gita is fully of his command to us. We have to obey. And like how we obey our parents, similarly we have to obey him. Our parents are also Anu like us. The whole world is like us. An ant is like me. An elephant is like me. That bush, that tree is like me. A part of that is one Atma. It is like me. Everything is symmetrical. Everything is saman, equal. So we all have to understand one thing very clearly. It is a very tough thing if you think, no, I can't get it. But it is simple. If you put everything to Lord's feet, look, Lord, I don't know this Atma and Paramatma. You, please show me yourself. Please show me. Daily you ask him. Beg with him. He will definitely do it. He's such a sweet person. He's a down-to-earth person. Humility is should learn from Lord. He will not trouble anybody until and unless you do something wrong against the Shastra, he will give punishment. So, we all of you take this 8 to 20 chapter, very, very important. Follow that and practice something so that you can go a little closer to God. Once you go close, automatically he will pick you up. He will pull you. It is like a magnet. A magnet, as a piece goes closer to magnet, stainless steel piece, the steel piece will get immediately attracted at some distance. Similarly, God will just catch you, keep moving closer to him. So with this, I want to just end my thing. And also I want to tell one shloka which God has pervaded everywhere. Brahmarpanam Brahmavihi Brahmagna Brahmanautam Brahmeiva tena gantavyam Brahma karma samadhina. This is because you people have done this fourth chapter, I'm telling you. This Agni, what you see when people do Omam, that is pervaded by Lord. Now, the what you pour ghee, that ghee is, you just imagine Krishna in that ghee. Complete Krishna is being poured into the Agni. Agni is completely surrounded by Krishna. There is no, don't see Agni, see Krishna in a round form. See a spoon what you have taken the ghee, that spoon is pervaded by God. The ghee is again God. And the person one who is pouring is fully pervaded. He is also God. God with Atma. There are only two people in this whole show. That is Paramatma. In his body there is one Atma, Anu. This is the whole irony of this whole thing. This whole world's irony is only this much. But it is difficult to digest. But it is not possible. It is not impossible. Sorry. So kindly, people take this as an important thing in your life, because your birth and death is inevitable. You have to be born. Once you become old, you have to pass off this body and get into another body. There's no end to it. Put an end to it. Not impossible. Put everything to Lord's feet. Tell him, you do it for me. You do it for me. You do it for me. Because you are doing it for me. I cannot do anything. I'm incapable. As you have told in fifth chapter, once you come to fifth chapter, he says very clearly that all the indriyas, that is eyes, nose, ear, nose, your skin, everything is pervaded by him only. So you can't do anything. If you have to smell, you have to take, he will smell for you and tell the Atma, come on, this is sweet, this is tasty, this is like this. This is fragments like this, he will say. So it is not possible for this Atma to do anything independently. This Atma gets its life only when he is pervaded inside. Then it becomes Sat. It is known as Sat. What is Sat? Sat is a person, one who is true. He is there. He is alive. He is alive. Now, I am talking to you in this video. This screen, what I am seeing is alive. It is Sat. It contains Lord of Anu. It contains God. God's body, all this is pervaded. All these Anu is pervaded. This is thing only I'm telling here. Everywhere, anything you take, anything in your house, in yourself, in your clothes, in your dress area, everything is pervaded by Lord and that Anu. This is the main tattva of the whole Bhagavad Geeta.